Hello everyone, thanks for joining me back in the Allan Block Workshop. Today, I want to talk about what is above the retaining wall that will affect the overall design. What I will show you today is how to apply sloped backfill and surcharges to a retaining wall design in our AB Walls design software. I will demonstrate how changing the location of the applied load changes the pressure experienced by the retaining wall, ensuring that as a designer, I consider the actual conditions that will be present on the site and account for them while designing. So let's jump in and show you how to do this. I want to start by defining both slopes and surcharges, and note that we are looking at how these impact the wall design when they are located above the retaining wall. A surcharge is an external load applied to the retained soil. Some examples of surcharges include sidewalks, roadways, buildings, and even other retaining walls. Slopes are less varied and occur when it is not feasible to build the retaining wall to a height that would allow for a flat backfill. AB Walls takes a conservative approach with sloped backfill and starts the slope directly behind the top block. In both cases, more weight is being added that the retaining wall needs to resist. Now, with both situations defined, I can look over my site plans and identify if my wall has either condition. To do that, I note which is my high elevation side, the side retaining soil, on my plans. For surcharges, I am looking for structures, parking lots and sidewalks, either called out by the key or noted on the plans. With slopes, I want to look at how the contour lines are drawn on the high elevation side of the retaining wall. If they run parallel to my retaining wall, I have to account for a slope. Once I determine if a slope or surcharge needs to be added in my design, I will include it on the appropriate panel section I created during my panel selection. From my observations, panel 3 has both conditions above, so we will use it for our example. I am going to start by modeling the slope of our site plan. I can define my slope either using the degree angle it forms or the run-to-rise ratio. In our case, I have an 8-foot run and a 2-foot rise, giving me a ratio of 4:1 or 14 degrees. I will type that into the slope above wall cells located in the lower left side of the section design screen. Once I've set the ratio, I can modify the height of the slope. The default value of 50 feet is intended to act as a continuous slope, but I can set this to match the 2-foot rise from my plan set, allowing me to create a broken back slope once it reaches the desired height. Next, I'll hit Calculate to apply the sloped backfill to our panel section visual and check the external safety factors with the updated condition. I can see that the internal and external safety factors have reduced with the additional soil and the active force, Ka, on the retaining wall has increased. I can also see that the internal and external safety factors have been reduced with the additional soil. The active force on the retaining wall has increased according to our sloped backfill configuration. This active force is recalculated each time a change to the slope backfill occurs, allowing a designer to analyze different configurations with a few clicks of a mouse. There may be cases where the slope above the wall cannot be reduced below the industry recommended 3:1 run-to-rise ratio. In these circumstances, it may be necessary to reinforce the slope with GeoGrid. AB Walls allows GeoGrid into the sloped backfill, and the designer can choose to add this when running internal compound stability. The spacing and length of GeoGrid used in the sloped backfill can allow the same configuration used in the retaining wall. I next want to model a driveway at the back of residential lot 12, as shown by the red rectangle. I will use a surcharge to show the effects on the retaining wall. With AB Walls, I have two options, surcharge and line load. The surcharge option functions as a continuous load from a specified point, while the line load option allows the designer to set a start and end point. I will use the surcharge option in this case. To apply the surcharge, I will need to give it a magnitude and a distance from the toe of the wall on the left. Additionally, I need to specify if this is a live or dead load, as they will apply loading differently. Use a live load for a situation where the load may not always be present, like a driveway. A dead load is used for things like buildings that will be present at all times. I will use 120 PSF as a live load at 10 feet from toe. Like slopes, I need to hit the calculate button to apply the change to the visual and rerun the internal and external calculations. The effect at 10 feet from the wall is minimal, as we can see our sliding factor of safety did not change from 2.786. However, as I move the driveway closer to the back of the reinforced soil mass, it will have a larger impact on the sliding safety factor. AB walls will dynamically account for loading depending on the location I set. If I had a situation where my applied slope or surcharge exceeds the design safety factors, I need to either increase the size of the reinforced soil mass or add more layers of grid to distribute the load. For steps on how to add or adjust geogrid layers, check out our how-to videos on modifying geogrids. During today's video, we covered how to identify situations on plans and add surcharges and slopes to a panel section in AB walls. We saw how adding sloped backfill changed the active force on the wall and how varying the location of a surcharge impacts how much loading force the reinforced mass experiences. All these features are built into the AB Walls design software to give the designer accurate information that can be applied to the wall design or overall site. For additional videos using the AB Walls design software, see allanblock.com. Always better, always Allan Block.